Did they manufacture 6 spacesuits for Apollo astronaut James A. Lovell? An Apollo astronaut got 3 spacesuits, one for training on Earth, one for flight and one as backup. James A. Lovell did fly on Apollo 8 as command module pilot and on Apollo 13 as mission commander. As CM pilot he needed an intravehicular suit and as commander an extravehicular suit. An intravehicular suit had only one set of gas connectors, an extravehicular suit had 2 sets. So did they build 3 intravehicular suits and another 3 extravehicular suits for James A. Lovell. Same situation with David Scott on Apollo 9 and 15 as well as John W. Young on Apollo 10 and 16. Gene Cernan flew Apollo 10 as lunar module pilot and Apollo 17 as commander, so he needed extravehicular suits only. Were some of the suits for Apollo 10 reused for Apollo 17? But Apollo 7 to 14 and 15 to 17 used different suit versions. See the related question.
The serial numbers of the Apollo spacesuits are documented on this NASA webpage. Each astronaut was assigned 3 suits for a particular mission, a flight suit, worn only during the mission, a backup suit, and a training suit. Some suits did double duty, most usually when an astronaut moved from a backup crew to primary crew for a later mission. The serial numbers of such reused suits are highlighted in color, with a unique color for each suit that was used more than once. Usually, a suit that had been a flight suit for a backup crew member became his training suit upon assignment to a subsequent prime crew. There are exceptions, such as Don Eisel's backup suit SN011 from his Apollo 7 prime crew assignment becoming his flight suit when he was assigned to the Apollo 10 backup crew. Training suits are often not listed earlier in the program. That's when they used A6L models instead of the final A7L model. Later in the Apollo program, because of budget cuts, a lot of used suits were reused, particularly for training and for backup crew. One suit that had been on the moon, Apollo 15 Scott, and 2 others that had been in space were actually reused for training. 5 suits were manufactured for Lovell. Suit 037 was actually flown on Apollo 8. Suit 052 was the backup for that flight. Suit 055 was used to train for Apollo 8. Suit 078 was actually flown on Apollo 13. Suit 074 was the backup suit for that flight, and was also his flight suit when he was on the Apollo 11 backup crew. Lovell's training suit for Apollo 13 is not given. However, considering how much NASA reused suits, it would not surprise me if Lovell's Apollo 8 backup and/or training suits were used for this purpose. They already were fit for him, anyway. David Scott had at least 5 suits. His training suit for his earlier mission is not given, he may have used an A6L model for that instead of an A7L. As previously noted, the suit that he walked in on the moon was later reused for training. Gene Cernan had 4 suits, his flight and backup suits for his 2 flights. No training suit is listed for Apollo 10, probably an A6L. He used Scott's been on the moon suit to train for Apollo 17. John Young had at least 6 suits. 2 were flight and backup for Apollo 10, no training suit was given. He had another flight suit on the backup crew for Apollo 13. 3 new suits were manufactured for Apollo 16, the unused suits from that flight became his flight and backup suits on the backup crew for Apollo 17.